Oh, I'm glad everyone here. Hello, hello. Hello, Loco guys from all around the world. Welcome to Virtual
Hi.
Meetup. Hey.
Hello, hi.
I see so many friends from India, from Malaysia, from Thailand, from Indonesia. Wow! Thank you for coming. So, in this virtual meetup, we will share the sharing from three amazing moms that also local guides, and they will share and teach us how to make the bag from the trash. What from the trash? Yeah. So, we specialize in the trash from plastic. So we discuss from coffee session, then from glass plastic. So after this, you can see three amazing speakers. And then before that, I kindly please mute your mic to listen to them. And then if you have something to say, it's okay. You can unmute your mic. And if you want to laugh, if you want to clap, it's okay to unmute your mic. Just relax, because we are friends here. Okay. First, I want you to meet Sandra from Bali Local Guys. Hello, Sandra. Please come forward.
Hi.
Hi, Sandra.
Hi.
Hello, Sandra. Hi.
Hi, everyone.
Okay, Sandra, you can start. Miss Rahmat, please. You can also start the slide for Sandra. Or you can... Sandra, how are you?
Good.
As you can see behind Sandra, there's a lot of bags made from from coffee sauces and other
things.
Oh, yeah. Many things. Okay, can you start the presentation? Can you tell a story when you start, and then how you prepare your bag, your craft?
Okay, thank you, Devi. Okay. Hi, everyone. My name is Sandra, Bali Local Guide, level 8. Recycling is really my passion, so I hope that the 30 minutes that I got will be enough to tell you about everything, because when I start talking about my passion, then I can go on for hours and hours. Okay, anyway, so when did I start it and how? So I started it since I came back from UK in 1992, because there we used to already separate our ways. So when I came back from UK, I started to separate my ways, like, it's not just plastic, but I was separating from paper, glasses, cans, even electronic gadgets, even batteries, like the time ink for the printers, and also material like clothings and destroyed napkins. I separate them all. So, and then, yeah. Just for myself, I mean, from my own household. And then 4 years ago, when my kids already left to study abroad, I have more time. I was thinking, what should I do with this extra time? So I did the research, and I was thinking, yeah, I want to do something with environment. So I did a small research, and I found out actually the most difficult items that to recycle and easily destroy our earth actually is the plastic. But it's not enough. So I did also more focusing what kind of plastic. And then I found out actually there is a certain plastic that is more, it's extremely difficult to recycle because they have they contains of a layer. So for example, this, sorry, I forget to prepare this one. So there is the plastic that we use to have a aluminium foil inside in the laminated. I need the sorry, I should have prepared this one. Anyway, okay, I got it. So this kind of plastic, this is a movie. So this kind of plastic have a laminating outside and the plastic and the aluminium foil. So it's three layers. To recycle, they have to separate between the laminating outside and the plastic and the aluminium foil. And then to be able to recycle it, they have also to have the same composition. So how thick is the aluminium foil, how thick is the plastic, and then they recycle. So the cost will be extremely high. Nobody wants to touch it because, yeah, it's just impossible. The end products will be just way too expensive. So I was thinking, what can we do with this kind of plastics that is nearly impossible to recycle? And then I found out that actually there are many people can make beautiful items from this product, from this plastic waste. So, and then I look in the YouTube, there are so many already in the West, they call it candy wrapper craft. So it's already so many instructions in YouTube. I was like watching them and different channels, and I couldn't understand a thing. So anyway, it's on the, maybe as you may know, on the December 2017 in Bali, we have a Mount Agung eruption. So during this eruption, I also did a charity, I sent donations to the victims. And when I was visiting the evacuees camps, one time I was sitting to have a lunch in the coffee shop there, and then I saw a brochure. The brochure was about the yayasan organization that recycling. So this, in the brochure, I saw they have this kind of product. So I thought, wow, this is wonderful. So after the story with Mount Agung subdued, I went there again. No, sorry, that time I went there, but it was closed. So, and then I called them and then I make appointment. So this is about like Yayasan Peduli Alam is over 100 kilometers from where I live. So I remember I checked the date. It was 22nd of May 2018. I went to Peduli Alam. But then I found out actually they didn't make anything themselves. They are collecting the rubbish from the beach and then they sent it to another place. So I got the number of the lady who can make these items, the recycling item. I call her and I make that appointment. So this Yayasan Peduli Alam is on the east coast of Bali, yes, east coast. And then the lady actually stays on the west coast of Bali. It's on the last city before we cross to Java by ferry, Gilimanuk. So it's like 167 kilometers from where I live. So within 2 days, the first day I went to the east for over 100 kilometers. And then the second day I went to the west for 167 kilometers. And wow, then when so I met far. The lady, yeah, we were talking, but actually she didn't have any ready material for me to use. So she just showed me all these rubbish bags. They are still all dirty. So I cannot do anything because the she told me how to do it, but I said, look, I need to see it. I need you to teach me. It's just talking like this with the hands. I have no idea. So yeah, I thought, okay, I have to go back here again. Okay, no problem. Next time I will bring my own material. But then the 2 days afterward, I also had a meeting regarding waste, rubbish. But in that building, I saw there is a group that learning how to make this material. So I just joined them. And then I thought, you know, it's like 6 days. Within 6 days, it's like a fate, you know. 6 days, I went to the east, and then I went to the west, and then out of the blue, it's just coincidence, I saw this group learning to use this coffee sachet. So I joined them. I got the teacher who did the workshop, and I asked her, and she's also very nice. She said, oh yeah, I can teach you. You don't have to pay for anything. I thought, wow, this is wonderful. So during that time, I also already asked my father, because I don't drink coffee. So I asked my father to collect his sachet and then sell it to me. While he's still collecting, and then my mother went to a coffee manufacturer, and then they got a promotional item. When they bought a certain item, they give this back for free. And my mother thought, you know, I already asked my father to collect the sachet. So he bought it for me. And I'm like, wow, you know, everything just put into places like that. So this is meant to be. I have to do it. You know, so I got the sachet from my father. I start asking my friends, my neighbors, and then also the sellers on the street, the coffee sellers on the street, we have everything here. And I thought, okay, this is, I just have to start it. So I collect some items, and then I met Ibu Agung, my tutor, and then I learned how to do it. And it's a big, actually, it's a long way. So I learned how to clean it, you know, how to wash it. And she told me, oh, just easy. After when you use it, and then you put the, you clean it, and then you put it anywhere, standing like this. And I thought, you know, I put it on my bathroom. It's all over the floor. And then the wind starts, and then it's flew. And it's a mess. So I really think how the easier way. So I start, okay, I use a stick. I use a stick, and then I put in the box, right? The stick I put in the box. And then if the stick is too long, it goes down, right? So I have to really measure, and then it's so many sticks, you know, so. And then I found out the water drip on the box, and it gets wet, and the box gets destroyed. So okay, the next one, what? Okay, I use styrofoam. So I start using styrofoam. It's like, you know, when every time when I do it, the whole floor of my bathroom is full with this styrofoam, with this plastic thing. And then suddenly, you know, I thought, this is just ridiculous. No, just to wash and dry, it already takes so much time, so much effort, and even I have no patience to really do it. So finally, I found a way that when you receive the sachet, normally it's only one side open, right? So just cut the other side and then wash it. And then you use a string, any kind of string is fine. No? So I found out that he can use this one. It's so easy. So just put everything on the rope, or a string, whatever, and then you can put together, hang it. You even don't need, from experience, you don't need it. You don't need the sun. You don't need anything. You can hang it inside on your bathroom, and it will get dry within 24 hours because it's plastic. So the material, they don't absorb the water. So you can make, and then you can put it how many layers you want, 10 layers, put everything together. Within one day, it will get dry. So easy, you know, and I spend like months and months trying the different techniques. And well, that's a process of learning.
Wow.
Yes, so, okay. That's
so the preparation
the story,
is very
how
long.
Do I start it and how do I find it? And should we start with the technique now? Hello, Devi?
Yeah. So the preparation is very long before you try to woven or making a bag.
Well, at the beginning, yeah, at the beginning, yes. And then after a while, yeah, when I find how the easier way to do it, then it's very fast. So when I got the waste, I just put everything in the big bucket with the water and the soap, and then just wash it. After wash it, I prepare the rope and then hang it straight away. So, you know, I can use a big bucket and I can do it just within 1 hour. I can get 100 material. Okay. So,
Sandra,
yes?
There's a question from Falguni. I think it's the same question with Anne. Can we use any size sachet for making bags?
Yes, actually, it doesn't have to be coffee sachet. It can be everything. Wood, peppermint.
No, different size. Maybe
Okay. One material, one item, you have to use the same
brand,
the same
size.
Yeah, the same brand, the same label, and the same, what do you call it? The
size.
Genis? No. Because, for example, in the, from Kapal Api, they have so many things, right? There is the black one, there is the 3-in-1 or different kind of kapal api or different kind of kapal api. So it has to be the same, because if not, we can use it but we cannot get the nice material, the nice motif. So like this, for example, this is from a kapal api, right? But if I use it, I can, if I mix it, I cannot get the same motif. So if I mix it, it will be like this. See? So the red one is on the bottom, and then the blue one is on the top, and then when I do it, it should be, some of them is intertwined together and cannot really separate. Top is the blue, the one at the bottom is the red. So when you have an artistic taste, yes, you can do it. I cannot, I don't have so much artistic taste, so I don't really do it. I just use a, you can. The answer is you can, if you want, you can mix from the same label. And why we have to use the same technique, the same sachet? Because we need the same width. If not the same width, then we cannot make it. Oh, show
it
you.
should be same head
Yeah,
or
the
width?
same width, the width
Oh,
of the
width.
packet. Yeah, because otherwise we cannot make it. When we do it, I think you will understand easier. Now if we are just talking like this, maybe you will get confused. Okay, so I think Davy asked you to prepare 10 pieces. Who already got 10 materials with you?
Yeah.
We have 23
yeah.
parties.
I already asked them.
So who already has 10? Because if not, I can just skip the first
like
this. How to fold it. Yeah, anyone else
already prepared?
Ewa, they had it.
I have
Ewa, they had it. It.
Okay, so. Ewa, they.
Yeah.
Indah. Well. Just two of you.
Indah, Ewa, they, Nisa. Guru Krishna.
Guru Krishna.
4, 5. Okay, let's do it.
Oh, so, do we need scissors, Mbak?
Is it already cut the top and the bottom?
Only the top, not the bottom yet.
Okay, I will. So you have to cut the bottom.
Okay.
Okay.
I have this. Then it becomes hollow, ya, Mbak?
Yes.
So it's going to be like this? Yeah.
Yes. So,
okay.
Okay, got it.
And they have to be the same size, right, Mbak? I mean, even when you cut the top and the bottom, it has to be the same?
No, just cut everything. Doesn't have to be the same. Just cut the top and the bottom. Because especially with coffee, where we have to cut it, because it's easier to wash and then to hang it on the string, you know.
I just you use just... tissue.
okay. Yeah, no problem. So if you just use a, if you just cut one and then it takes longer to get dry.
Yeah.
So when you just cut two like this, if it's a coffee sachet, and then you just put it under the running water, if it's your own, and then you just put it like this, if it's your own.
Yeah, that would be a lot easier.
Yeah, so just cut both, put under the tap, and then just leave it, and then it will get dry. Okay.
Okay.
Ready? Everyone ready with the both sides get the cut? Okay, now take a piece of paper. This is will be our pattern.
You make clothes. You also use pattern, right?
This is our
let me get paper.
Okay, so the width. This is the full, right? The top and the bottom is the cut. So the width, like this, we make a measurement with the width. So this is the width.
Can I put it like this, Ma?
Like this. You can cut it, yes, correct.
What do we do again, Mbak? Sorry, I kind of lost it.
The width of the
on the sachet.
This is the top. This is the bottom.
Oh, okay.
This is the width. Measure the width.
Yeah. And then what do we do with
the paper?
Just cut it. Just cut it.
According to the width.
Okay.
Cut the paper according to the width of the plastic.
Let's cut it.
Okay. Done.
Mm-hmm.
And then fold it into two. And then fold it again. So four. Okay, I repeat again. This is the width. We fold into two and then fold again.
So you double fold it.
Yeah.
So this is a quarter of the width.
Okay. Right. When you fold half, you fold again, it becomes a quarter.
And then you can fold the top.
Of the plastic, like this. Fold it. Once you fold it, you fold towards inside. So this is the inside.
So after this, we open it up.
Okay. We fold the top. You fold.
We fold it again.
You fold, right?
Yeah. And with the button as well.
Fold it inside. Fold it towards the inside.
Okay. Hold on.
So the front and the back. And this is the inside. You fold inside.
Does it have to be symmetrical, Ma? Harus sama atau dilipat?
No, you can fold anything. Just to begin, just fold it, just the top fold into anything.
Oh, inside, yeah. I do it the other way around. Sorry.
Now we use the pattern, right? This is the pattern. We fold the bottom.
No, I have to.
We fold the bottom. If it's the plastic is too weak, right? Just cut it.
Yeah,
but cut the left.
I think mine is like long.
So this is the extra, right? Let's cut it.
So after we do this, we put. Where do we put the paper again, Ba?
So we use it like this, and then we fold on the back the extra plastic we cut.
I lost the last one. So we before doing that, we after we fold it inside.
And then you use the pattern.
Paper.
You fold the bottom.
I fold the bottom up. Okay.
And then the extra, you just cut it off.
Oh, okay. So the extra I have here, I just cut it off.
Yeah, just cut it off.
Okay.
Oh no, right. Not from the beginning. Okay. The top we fold. We fold the top. And then fold inside.
Okay.
And then we use the pattern. We fold the bottom. We cut off the extra plastic that is way wider than the pattern. We cut it off, right? And then we fold again inside. So this is the material that we need.
Mine is not that neat.
Nai, you can meet with Davy to learn.
Yeah, I think I will. At least I get the idea of doing it in the beginning.
Yeah. So this is our pattern, okay? And then if we have to wait for all of you to make 8 pieces of it, I think it will be too long, right? So you can do it, you can cut it, and then in the meantime I just show the others how to do it.
Okay. It's so easy. How many do we need for this?
And why I choose this one? Normally this is my bag. This is my shopping bag that I proudly bring around everywhere with me. Instead of buying the branded one, I'm more proud to bring this one around with me. This is a shopping bag. And inside, there is my bag. So when I do shopping, I just carry this bag. I pick it up and this is, I carry it out. Okay. So inside of my bag, there is another bag inside. See how beautiful this is.
Wow.
I have my own tumbler.
Tumbler.
Wow, it's very lovely.
This is 1.5 liter. I have a power bank. Is to bring my power bank and cable around. So you see how strong this bag is. I use it for already more than 2 years. And why I like it? Because, when I show to people, for example, wow, what is it? You know, we are talking. And then when I just show like this, look, it's so easy. I just dismantle this bag in front of them and they were like, oh, you know, what are you doing? Don't destroy it. I said, no, no need to destroy it. Look, I don't need a needle. I don't need glue, nothing. I can just dismantle my bag like this. So this is the material we use. So instead of teaching the others how to do it, I just show how this bag made from this material. Okay.
Oh.
So are you going to fold 8 pieces? Actually, you need 7.
Okay.
Are you going to fold it, or do you want me to just show straight away how to do it?
Just show the demo.
How to do it, and then yes, and then after you can prepare, and then maybe we can arrange another time when you already have the material to use and to practice. I think that's easier, right? Yeah, right. Excuse me, I need a drink first. Okay. So, what is the easy? I always take like this. Take one. This is number one. Okay. Number two is outside. Sorry, outside number one. Number three is outside number two. Number four. It's outside number three, and then we lock it inside the next piece.
So we need four, Mbak.
It's like, yes, this is like a hashtag, right?
I only got two.
Four like this, and then the inside we pull out, that one inside we pull out.
Wow. You have to lock it. Nice.
Yeah.
Okay. I think we need to have a repetition on that. Which one goes inside and outside?
Okay. I repeat, yeah. This is number one.
Yeah.
Number two, outside number one.
Let me just write it down, Mbak.
Well, actually, do you know our my Instagram, Core Bali, Core Core Bali 2018. I already post the step by step in drawing.
Core.
Echoing again. Okay.
Everyone muted because. Huh? What's wrong? Sandra, where are you? Hello? Sandra?
She left, Devi.
Disconnected, maybe.
Yeah, I guess it's disconnected.
So, is it easy, everyone?
Not at all, Debbie. Not at all.
For you, it's easy.
If you are seeing it directly, it will be a lot easier. Or if you have videos or something.
Yes.
Yeah. I have the step. Also, Sandra has Instagram for learning, and I have the video on YouTube. You can see. After this, I will write it in chat box. Oh, where is Sandra? So she don't come back? She doesn't come back?
Not yet, but not yet. Whoa, what's that?
Sandra.
Joining again. Devi, with the length of scale, can you tell us how much is the length with the scale? Exactly.
They, that's why Sandra teach us how to do the pattern with the white paper. Yeah, okay. Because each sachet has different size, so we have to make sure or measure with the pattern using the white paper first. That's why what paper does it, because we need to measure. We need the pattern first. After that, we can know the width, this width. So yeah. After when we woven, because it's different. We cannot make this long. Sandra, hello, who's Sandra? Okay.
No, it's nice. And this, she told 1, 2, 3. All are different patterns. So how many you need? Number 1, number 2, number 3, and 4.
Yes, minimum we have to have 8 or 4, Sandra?
Oh, 10. 7 or 10.
7 or 10.
Yeah.
You need to fold like this. 10 pieces. Like this. 10 pieces first. And then after that, you can learn how to do this, because this without glue, without yarn, without needle, just put it inside of put it like yes. This without glue, right?
Correct. It is locking and popping. Locking.
Okay. So good night. Can I continue with that one?
Yeah.
Okay.
She left again. What's happening?
I think it's the connection.
Yeah, I think the connection.
Well, I think yeah, maybe someone doesn't want me to teach you. Every time I start the step, it gets cut off. Anyway, I try to repeat again. This is number 1, right? Number 2 outside number 1. Number 3 outside number 2. Number 4 outside number 3. And then lock inside. This number 4, right? And then glue inside next to it. So it's like this. It's like interlocking it. Okay. And when you already do it, that one go inside. This is inside, right? Pull out. The one inside, pull out. The one inside, pull out, and then pull out. So this is the basic. Okay. So this is we need 4 pieces. The next one, because we already have 1 here, you can take any one. This is your number 1. Okay. So this is the number 1. We repeat the same step. Number 2 outside number 1, but we need number 2 to have a gap next to it. So the number 2 cannot go like this. can, but this is different technique. So I'm teaching you the one with the gap. Number two, this is number one. After we do the basic, this is number one. Number two, outside number one, give a gap with the one next to it. Okay, so number two, outside number one, as the same one. And then number three, outside number two. Number four, outside number three, and then lock inside the one next to it. Okay. And then pull again the one inside.
Okay.
So, this is the basic. You can repeat it. Number one, number two, number three, number four. Go inside lock. You continue.
Okay. That is the base, right?
Yeah. This is the basic technique.
Basic technique.
So I guess the session should be long enough, ya, Pak. Because mine is a bit diagonal. Mine is not wide, but long. Yours is wide instead of long, right?
No, you can cut it, right? But it's long.
Okay. Because this is like very short. And to put number one to number two to the three, then I'm running out of space.
You already pulled the top and the bottom?
Yeah, the top and the bottom.
Kok gendut banget sih itu?
Yeah, makanya that's why mine is very white.
Where is your pattern?
My pattern is here.
And then measure it. The pattern.
So the pattern is too big, yeah?
So the pattern has to be a quarter of the width.
Yeah.
Evenly. Yours is not evenly. That's why you're facing problem. You need lot to practice.
Oh, for sure.
So now I explain why we need a pattern, because a quarter, because this is the first block is 1, 2, 3, 4. That's why one piece divided by 4. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. So a quarter.
Okay.
That's the theory.
Sandra, okay. To make your big bag, how many sets do we need?
That one I think is my big bag. I think is around 500.
500?
Yes.
Wow.
500 like this? Or 500 sachets?
Well, 500 sachets becomes one sachet become one piece. So 500.
That's a lot.
This is around 300.
Oh. 300.
Wow. That's beautiful. Yeah.
And actually, something like this, sometimes because I give a calculation, how many do I need? Oh, none. Anyway,
Sandra.
Yes.
From the far is like a batik. The motif is like batik.
Yeah. The pattern. The pattern is. Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
I'm looking at your Instagram.
This is a tumbler holder. Okay.
Do you have a backpack, Sandra?
No. Because I don't use backpack.
No backpack.
No, I don't use backpack. And some I also. Oh, I forget. Wait. Can I disappear for me? Look at my item. Wait.
Yeah. Okay. I want to say hello to Izumi. Hello, Izumi from Japan.
So sometimes I cannot find the nice motif from a material, so I use the inside, the silver color. Okay, you can use the inside.
Wow, it's a bell.
But I think I got it, but because it's but because
so
it's too white, yeah, because it's too white, it doesn't look as beautiful as Masandra's. I think it's wrong measurement from the beginning. But I got the number one, number two, number three, number four.
Yay!
Okay. So actually, the ones from Jakarta, you can meet with Devi, and Devi can teach you.
I will. We will.
Okay, so this is the silver.
Wow.
So is that from what Sa said that, Sandra? Black and white.
Inside, Mbak. No, the silver is from the inside.
The black is just the lining. So this is silver.
But the silver is from the inside, I believe, ya, Mbak?
Yes. This is Nutrisari.
But you know what?
Have you tried making belt or jewelry from the silver one? Belt or jewelry? We can make a belt. Girls wear belt on the top and all, na? Have you tried that? With the silver, we can make it. And my second question is, you put handles and all, do you stitch yourself handle, the strap and all you're putting?
No, I send it to the tailor to make it for me.
Yeah, that only lining with lining, strap and all, you need a tailor.
Yes.
Thank you.
Well, if you know how to make bags for your strap, you can do it. But I don't have a sewing machine, so I said it earlier. Okay. But we can
I have. Yeah.
So like this. This is the bracelet.
Wow.
Bangles.
Oh, nice. Okay, Sandra.
Beautiful. That's nice.
Wow.
Wow, my God.
So you can make many things.
Sandra, I think your time is up. Already 1 hour.
Beautiful.
Okay. Yeah. Candy basket. All right. Okay. Thanks, everyone.
Speakers.
I'm making the
new
one.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sandra, but stay tuned.
Okay. You can have my WhatsApp, and then you can ask me whatever problems. Oh, I have this material I want to make, how to hold it and things like that. Don't worry, just ask me and I will try, you know, to help. Okay, so thank you everyone for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sandra.
Beautiful.
Thanks, Mbak. Aku penasaran, jadi aku mau coba lagi.
Semangat, mencoba.
Okay.
Thanks, Mbak.
Sandra, Mbak Sandra, makasih banyak ya.
Sama-sama.
I'm late, but I think I got some in mind. I will try and. If I get a question, I will ask you.
Yeah, sure. I got the idea now with all this reasoning.
Yes. So you can also check on my Instagram. They have I put some steps how to wash, how to hang, how to make dry, and also how to do the first basic of the weaving. Good.
I have one question.
Wow.
I have one question. We have to continue like this. Continue like this. And what about the other layer to on the top?
Yeah, that's the second step.
Okay.
So it's the same. So it's the same. It's one outside, number two outside, number three outside, and then one block contains of four pieces. So you can continue. You know what? Prepare your material first.
Okay.
As many as possible.
Okay.
And then Devi can arrange for the second one for the people who really interested to make it. So you already can prepare the folding one like this.
Yes.
Yeah.
So we just.
I think that'll be a good idea. Mm.
Right.
We need to sure as well.
sure.
Okay. All right. So, thank you, and back to Devi.
Thank you. Good job.
I will introduce you, Miss Ilsria from Malaysia Local Guys. I met her last year, and I found that she also liked to craft, and she also make this craft and selling to and teaching to other moms. So welcome, Miss Husnia from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Hello, come forward, please. Husnia, where are you? Husnia.
Hi, can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you. Hello.
Hi.
Husnia, everybody meet Husnia. Say hello to Husnia.
Hi,
hello, Husnia.
Hi.
How are you?
Hi.
Hello. Hi, Bu. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam. Waalaikumsalam. It's a pleasure. It's a pleasure to meet all of you. My first time. Thank you to Devi for the invitation. And Sandra, she's an excellent teacher. And she's so much better than me. Very good. Bu Sandra, I have to learn from you as well. Okay, what is it that where do you want me to start, Devi?
Yeah, please tell us about you and your daily activities so we can get know you better.
Okay, yes, as we have been long here. I think everybody might be feeling sleepy, so I briefly go through with you. Basically, I come from the corporate world. I work with Shell Malaysia for 30 over years. I am married with four children, and now I have four grandchildren from my eldest daughter. Yeah, but I have three boys who are all not married yet. So you can ask me to be your future mother-in-law. I had left Shell at the age of 52, and I went into my own small business because my children are all grown up and they are all graduates and they are all working. So what happens is that's where I started crafting. I started sewing, and I did this bag like Sandra, Bu Sandra is doing. Yeah, it's made. Yeah. It's made of plastic rice. So the rice.
Plastic rice.
Yeah. So the rice that we have in Malaysia is packed in plastic bags. There are different brands. So the blue ones are different brands. The green one are different brands. So these are multi brands of rice plastic paper. So it's very easy for me to keep them because I just go to the restaurant and ask them to keep for me. So it becomes so many. So from there, we start making bags. Like Bu Sandra, we make also the bottle tumbler, baskets, is the same. But Bu Sandra doesn't have to do anything, just interlock, right? But this paper, this plastic, we have a template. And the method is the same like Bu Sandra, but we staple it. We staples them because it's a piece of plastic. Show you. Assuming this is the plastic, what we do is we fold them. We fold them like this, like Bu Sandra did just now. Yeah, and what we do, there is no hole because we cut them. We cut the plastic like this. Then we fold them like Bu Sandra was folding. And there's no hole to go like Bu Sandra did. So what we do is we put inside this hole. Yeah. So it's already become like this. Yeah.
Oh, also make a ring. Like a ring and then you staple it.
Exactly. So we staple it here. Yeah, put inside. So after that, like Bu Sandra did just now, she takes four pieces and she interlock. So we interlock the same thing as well, like what Bu Sandra is doing. After we have enough, then we can weave it. We start with this part here. We start with here, and this is where you need to know how to curve it up. Right, Bu? Bu Sandra?
Yes.
So then we weave until whatever width you want, whatever height, whatever width you want. And then here, we will make it neatly, fold it neatly here, so that it becomes like this. It's all folding. After that, we just take this handle, we put it here. We buy this handle. Sometimes we don't have this handle, we take leather and we sew it and we make a string. And I know how to sew, so I sew it myself.
Nice.
Okay.
So do you sell the product? Do you sell the products or?
Yes, we do. Most of the time, what we do is we make this as a gift, birthday gift. Friends that come, like Devi, I didn't have the opportunity to give you one back because it was a short time spent with Devi. So we give it away. If people want to buy, for me, I sell it really cheap. Basically, I just want to save the plastics and to show my handicraft. But there are many friends outside there who sell them. They sell at 45 ringgit, Malaysian ringgit, 50 ringgit. But if anybody wants to buy from me, the most I will sell at this bag, this size, at 25 ringgit.
Ringgit.
Yeah. I made so many such that I haven't done the handles. Yeah. Different sizes. No handle yet. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like so this.
Oh, cute! Purple!
Yeah, small ones. So no handle yet. I just was excited to do these things, to show my students what are the sizes that we can make. And then so that when you continue to do, like Bu Sandra have taught, you must always finish it and continue to do it so that you can remember. If you just do the four, like what Bu Sandra does, and stop, you will never get to make a bag. Yeah, Bu Sandra?
Correct. Can I suggest you something? My bag, this bag, this is the rope for the curtain.
Oh, rope. Oh, okay. Good idea.
So, yeah, you just use it, you know, buy the matching colors and then just knot it inside or you can stitch it.
Okay, good idea. I can learn more from Bu Sandra.
Or this one I use from the same material.
Mm-hmm.
Also, it's a different way to do it.
Okay. Okay. I have some slides, so Devi, you can just go through the slides. Briefly go through the slides.
Yes. Okay. Mas Rahmat, okay. Okay, the slide is already on. Okay, next slide, please.
Yeah, just move the slides. People can just read it, yeah.
This is... It's from what the rice package, right? Okay, next.
Ustia,
yes.
If you make, do you know this technique? When you have already a flat material, then you can make this kind of technique. Why I'm like this?
Sandra, your camera,
I know how to do it. I don't know how to do it.
At the right top,
there is a circle. Just press that.
You need to tap on your screen to actually see that. It looks like two arrows. So once you tap on it, it will flip back to selfie mode.
Okay, back to Ustia. Where's the presenting? Mas Rahmat?
Yeah, you can just move on. These are my friends who learn from me. Yeah.
Okay, can you tell us about your goal? Why you teach them?
So my intention is that so that mothers at home don't waste your time watch TV or do nothing or gossiping, but spend those time usefully. And our time to me is very valuable. So for me, I never stop doing things. I don't watch TV. Don't ask me about the artists. I don't know. I don't know about gossiping. I don't gossip very much. I do sometimes, but not most of the time. So to me, I do craft, I do sewing, and do there's many other crafts that I do. Now what I'm doing is helping Tawau, the Sabah, if you know Sabah, where Sabah is. Yes, they have very high COVID cases there. So what I'm doing now, I lead a volunteer to sew PPE for them. Yeah, PPE, protective suit for them.
APD, ya, kalau di sini. A protective suit for doctor or for medical?
It will be for the nurses, the frontliners. They don't have enough, so we help them make. So I just started with the volunteers 3 days ago. So I and another friend in my own shop, I saw the suit, the top only. And then another three friends, they go and sew at home, the headgear, and the boots. These are all made of woven material. Really hot if they were to wear them.
Oh, really hot?
Very hot, because the air doesn't come in to the material. So when they finish using it, they just rip it off and they throw it away.
Okay. Last question. Do you have any inspirational story that you can share to us about your recycle journey? Maybe about your teacher, or maybe about your student or your colleague.
I have a lot of students who learn this bag, but they don't have much passion in doing it dedicatedly. So I have a friend who is 66 years old, and her sister who is about 80 years old, who always do these baskets. They do baskets. They
80
do
years baskets. Old?
Yes, 80 years old. And she's very good in doing recycled material. She does baskets, she does tumblers, she does, what do you call that? Wallets, small wallets. And she doesn't sell them, but she gives them away for free. And she has a lot of them all the time she's doing. Very passionate about it. One of the best that I've seen, yeah.
That's so inspiring. So they did it for free and maybe for therapy, right?
Yes, for therapy as well, yeah. Because when they start weaving and making baskets, they forget about their worries, about their pain or whatever. They're just happy going and making those baskets.
Oh, so making craft also therapy.
Making craft is a therapy. So that's all from me tonight. Thank you very much for listening.
Thank you, Hostia.
Thank you, Hostia. I have a question. Do they sell online or what? Your students or some ladies, if they want to earn income?
No, we don't.
They should. Because there are some ladies who need income. They can sell it online and all. They can generate money for their family. Because it's so nice technique and you have variety of things. Thank you so much. All the best.
Welcome.
Hostia, can I share something with you?
Yes.
When you already make, instead of making a package, you already have it on a piece, right? Do you know there is another technique that you can make something like this, you know?
Mm-hmm.
This is using a flat material. So it's different technique. And you can make, this is the
same technique. The purse, yes. Very nice. Yeah.
So this is different technique from what I'm teaching today.
Mm-hmm.
So you make, this is for example, I use it as a, to cover a jar. So, but this one we need to put together. See? So this is, this is one line, two lines, three lines, four lines, and then put together like this.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Wow.
So this is if I have a flat instead of a package, then I make this technique instead.
Mm-hmm. Very nice.
For me, rather than make it a package and then use the stapler, I do it different way.
Oh, very good. Yeah.
Yeah. Very different nice. Technique. Different technique for the packet and different technique for the flat plastic.
Mm-hmm. One
piece
very
of plastic.
Good.
Yeah.
Very good.
The silver clutch is very beautiful. Sandra, please hold it. We'll click photo. That silver clutch.
This is not finished yet. So I need to make a tip and then I have I want to make a handler, but I have already one lady like this. So this is just a normal clutch, already with the strip.
Yep.
And
beautiful, beautiful. Thanks.
This is for the Christmas and New Year party. This is my party.
Yeah, for the party.
Yeah. And with a small different size of the
purse.
It's very bling bling.
Wow. Yes.
The coin, you know, I can use it as a keychain.
Yeah. It looks like the latest bag, you know, when they have the big, when the bag has a small pouch. Inside or outside.
So this is the set.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Sandra. Thank you, Husnia. Thank you for sharing your stories. I hope it will inspire other of the guys. Okay, now the third speaker is Juwarni, Ibu Juwarni. Hello, Ibu Juwarni. I will presenting in Bahasa because Miss Juwarni is not English fluently. Hello, Bu Juwarni. Bu Juwarni.
Yo.
Mana? Bu? Halo, Bu.
Juwarni. Masih mute, harus di-unmute dulu. Mute.
Unmute dulu.
Ini Bu Juwarni Pauh yang dari mana itu ya?
Ya, dari mana? Kan waktu itu ketemu.
Bu Juwarni Muntiga ini.
Hai, I'm Shirish. Thank you for joining. Thank you for joining to me in this local guide meetup.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Shirish.
Hi, Shirish.
Hello.
Oh, Bu Juwarni is on.
Hi, Bu Juwarni is on. Yeah. Okay. Can you hear my voice? Bu Devi? Hello. Hello, Bu Devi.
You are one more speaking now.
Your voice is breaking down. Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hi. Hi. Hi.
Yeah, hello. Hello.
Yeah, very good. Okay.
Yeah, very good. Okay.
Halo.
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 Udah
halo.
Silakan perkenalkan.
Udah silakan silakan perkenalkan.
Halo, my name is Juwarni from Batu Local Care. Bisa dengar suara saya, Bu Devi?
Ya.
Ya, bisa dengar.
Ya.
Ya, oke. Oke, my name is Juwarni from Batu Local Care. I'm so sorry because my English is not good. Tapi saya pakai bahasa Indonesia saja ya. Maaf, saya bahasa Indonesia saja soalnya bahasa Inggris saya kurang begitu lancar, takut salah nanti. Oke, selamat malam semuanya. Salam kenal buat yang belum kenal dengan saya. Saya dari Batu ini. Itu rupanya ada Bu Nisa. Selamat malam Bu Nisa. Ada Nyai Nurjana juga. Selamat malam Bu Devi juga. Selamat malam.
Halo.
Selamat berjumpa kembali ini. Mas Rahmat, gimana kabarnya? Bu Sandra?
Baik, baik, halo. Baik.
Salam kenal buat yang belum kenal ini, yang dari Malaysia. Dari mana tadi itu? Saya lupa.
Ya,
oke. Iya. Bu Husni ya tadi dari Malaysia ya. Salam kenal dari Batu ini. Gimana nih kabarnya Bu Nisa? Gimana kabarnya? Udah enggak hujan ya di sana?
Tadi udah ke Batu.
Oh iya. Di sini juga enggak hujan.
Iya.
Oke, bisa ya, dimulai ya.
Halo.
Halo. Iya, sudah bisa dimulai Bu Devi? Oke, saya hanya ingin berbagi pengalaman saja. Saya kan juga suka ngumpulin ini apa?
untuk daur ulang. Tapi saya ngumpulinnya bukan kayak Bu Sandra tadi, dari bukan dari bungkus kopi, saya dari ini, dari gelas-gelas ini, gelas ini, tapi yang saya pakai ininya, lehernya ini kita gunting nanti dari apa, dari gelasnya sari apel atau gelasnya bekas minuman-minuman gini semua bisa, dari teh-teh gini. Nah, yang kita ambil itu ininya, lehernya. Nah, nanti kita bikin jadi tas yang cantik. Jadi saya kebetulan belajar ini dari ibu-ibu PKK. Kebetulan saya kan bergabung di PKK, jadi saya Pokja 3. Jadi ya belajar sama-sama ibu-ibu, cuma mengisi kegiatan waktu luang itu aja. Sama daripada kita nganggur, kita buang ini kan saya nggak bisa terurai ya, jadi kita manfaatkan untuk bahan-bahan tas yang bisa bernilai jual tinggi. Kalau kita jual nanti kan buat income ini. Nah, terus kalau kita ngumpulin ininya, kalau kita habis minum itu nggak buang, jadi kita ngumpulin. Kadang-kadang ada tetangga hajatan apa, nggak malu-malu buat ngumpulin itu teh gelas apa bekas-bekas gelasnya aku, kita kumpulin gitu. Soalnya kita kalau mau bikin tas, kita sebanyak ini, sebesar ini, kita butuh sekitar 120-an ini. 120-an lagi. Gelasnya ini, lagunya aqua ini. Nah, gitu. Jadi bahan-bahan yang kita perlukan ini, gelas-gelas aqua gini. Ini gelas aqua apa aja. Semacam ini tadi barusan saya potong jadi gini. Ini dari brosem, gelasnya brosem, ini dipotong, diambil layernya aja. Terus ini untuk pengikatnya nanti, ini kayak kabel yang buat mengikat kabel itu. Biasanya kita beli di apa, peralatan jahit satu roll gitu. Kemudian cutter yang kita butuhkan, ini cutter sama gunting, terus sama apa, tang kalau untuk ini, untuk ngikat ini. Kalau banyak kan kita nanti biar tangannya enggak itu apa, enggak sakit. Jadi buat muter gini loh, kalau tang kecil itu. Nah, terus kita butuhkan pita-pita kecil. Pita kecil semacam ini pitanya, kayak gini nih. Lah buat nanti buat nutup ini, kalau biar kelihatan cantik, nutup ini. Nutup lehernya gelas tadi, itu gelas aqua tadi, itu kita tutup gini sampai tertutup. Kalaupun misalnya enggak ditutup sama pita, misalnya dari teh gelas kan ada gambarnya itu, hijau-hijau gini dari brosem, kita biarkan aja nanti jadi cantik nanti. Kalau pingin yang lebih elegan lagi, ya kita bungkus nanti jadinya seperti ini. Gitu. Nah, kemudian buatnya kira-kira kalau kita rutin ya, paling sekitar 3-5 harian mungkin selesainya. Soalnya kan lama ini. Ini harus kita ikat satu-satu gini. Pakai yang tadi, pengait tadi itu. Kita ikat satu-satu gini sampai banyak itu dulu.
3 days, 4-5 days.
Untuk selesainya. Ya, ya bisa satu minggu juga, tergantung kalau kita rutin gitu, ya bisa anu. Soalnya kan kita ngikat-ngikat gini. Belum nanti ini kalau dibungkus-bungkus seperti ini bisa satu minggu satu tas. Gitu, jadi agak lama. Kalau langsung gini ya cepet. Ini kan nggak usah dipelipit pakai pita. Gitu. Jadi langsung di sini diginikan aja, nanti langsung diikat. Terus nanti diikat, kalau udah banyak kan diikat, ini diikat lagi, akhirnya jadi banyak seperti ini. Kalau sudah diikat jadi satu. Ini seperti ini jadinya. Kalau pengen apa namanya? Pengen bagus lagi, dalamnya diberi puring seperti ini.
Puring.
Iya, di puring ini jadi manis kayak gini. kan mewah. Nanti kalau untuk pesta pun kita kita layak dibawa ke pesta ini, tas ini. Gitu. Jadi untuk alasan saya kenapa bikin tas ini, karena kan ya mengurangi sampah, juga menyelamatkan bumi. Biar tidak terlalu banyak sampah, karena plastik ini kan susah terurai. Jadi biar gelas-gelas tadi yang dibuang percuma, biar bisa mempunyai nilai jual tinggi, ya kita bikin seperti ini. Jadi saya kumpulnya sama ibu-ibu PKK, enggak punya komunitas khusus gitu, komunitasnya ya ibu-ibu PKK itu aja gitu. Jadi kita belajar bareng-bareng, sama kalau habis punya ilmu gini, kita tularkan ke ibu-ibu PKK gitu, kalau di tempat saya seperti itu. Jadi kita belajar bareng-bareng, minimal kita pakai sendirilah walaupun tidak dijual. Kalau teman saya ada yang salah satu memang, dia kan memang nggak punya pekerjaan lain, jadi memang jadi spesial buat ini, daur ulang ini, dijual dia. Kalau kita jual ini bisa 150.000, paling murah bisa 200. Ini.
Loh, mahal banget.
Iya, ini loh. Ini.
150.
Iya, bisa 150-an ini kalau dijual.
Itu kok bisa?
Itu kok bisa warna?
Kenapa?
Bisa.
Ya, ini kan dipelipet sama pita merah. Terus sih, terus handle-nya pakai handle jadi. Jadi kan kelihatan mewah. Kalau yang pakai rantai seperti ini. Ini bisa apa pegangannya pakai rantai seperti ini. Tergantung mau yang gimana. Kalau yang kecil gini paling sekitar 50.000 kalau kita beli. Soalnya furingnya aja ini sekitar 25.000 kita. Kalau beli sama ini resleting apa itu, ini 25.000 gitu. Kita kalau furingnya memang pesan di teman yang spesial bikin furing ini, kan terlalu lama kalau kita bikin furing gitu. Jadi kalau kita jual ini ya jadi 50.000-an lebih nih lah. Ini talinya aja 20.000 ini, yang emas ini.
Oh iya.
Kalau yang pengen yang lebih murah, ini tapi kan tampilannya agak jelek gini. Ini juga sama bahannya, cuma kita ini pengaitnya pakai tali kur. Tapi kan beda tampilan ini sama ini kan beda. Kalau ini murah ini. Segini ini kalau dijual cuma 35.000 ini, teman-teman kalau jual. Paling buat souvenir apa gitu kalau dijual. Gitu. Nah, kan beda sama yang gini tampilannya. Kalau sudah dipelipit pita kan bagus.
Iya.
Kalau ini bahannya pakai tali kur. Sama bikinnya, cuma bedanya pakai tali kur aja ini. Jadi, kalau ini Pak juga. Iya. Nah, gitu. Jadi kita belajarnya juga sama-sama di BKK gitu aja Bu Devi. Ini kita sering-sering ilmunya sama ibu-ibu BKK habis pertemuan BKK gitu, pengisiannya ya bikin-bikin seperti ini. Gitu.
Kalau tadi
kurang jelas
bahan-bahan.
Kalau bahannya kan ngumpulinnya dari orang-orang hajatan gitu. Kalau teman saya teman apa tetangga itu disuruh ngumpulin nanti dibeli. Tadi dibeli terus, iya dibeli gelas-gelas ini nanti dikumpulin sama tetangga-tetangga itu, terus dibeli sudah dalam keadaan gini. Tadi kita beli sudah dalam keadaan sudah ini, sudah digunting ini. Digunting sudah rapi gitu kalau teman saya. Jadi kita nggak usah, kalau ngumpulin sendiri kan lama banget Bu Devi. Kan kita nggak setiap hari minum ini, minum yang gini. Yang pasti ya minum yang, kalau yang gelas-gelas gini, kalau hajatan baru kan ini paru banyak gitu. Jadi ngumpulinnya dari tetangga-tetangga itu yang biasa kadang-kadang pesan itu sama yang apa pemulung itu loh, yang biasanya beli daru ulang itu. Nah, kalau sekarang agak dipermudah karena kita kan ada bank sampah. Kalau di tempat saya kan ada bank sampah. Jadi ini kita kumpulin, nah kita sendirikan, dan nah kita bikin ini. Sekarang iya ada bank sampah, jadi agak mudah dari ininya. Tapi ya kita harus nyortir itu satu-satu. Kan enggak semua satu apa namanya? Satu jenis ya, ada yang dari aqua, ada yang dari Cleo, ada yang dari Teglas. Kalau dari Teglas semua gitu bagus sekali, walaupun enggak dipelipit gitu kelihatannya bagus. Tapi cuma tampilannya enggak begitu elegan, enggak begitu mewah kayak yang dipelipit gini. Kalau yang sudah dipelipit gini kan jadi bagus. Gitu. Agak mewah kan kesannya ya. Jadi kalau untuk kondangan sudah ini sudah layak ini. Kalau saya ke kondangan ini tak bawa kondangan ini sudah kayak tas mahal padahal dari lehernya aqua ini. Dan kelihatan kan orang enggak mengira ini kalau dari lehernya aqua. Udah mengira enggak ini kalau dari lehernya aqua? Kan enggak kan? Lah ya makanya kalau sudah nanti kapan-kapan kalau ada waktu lagi kita belajar sama-sama bikinnya. Soalnya prosesnya agak lama ini. Kan kita harus ini gunting-gunting ini dulu dikumpulin kayak seperti ini. Nah kalau sudah ini mesti diginikan dulu sampai banyak baru ini dipertemukan ini itu. Tapi sebelumnya kalau ingin bikin seperti ini harus dililit pakai pita yang kayak gini nih, pita yang kecil kayak gini. Jadi ini ditempelin selotip yang atas bawah itu. Nah, kita lilit kayak
yang atas. Yang atas.
Iya. Iya, pakai selotip itu ya. Sampai ini sampai selesai kalau ngelilit itu. Sampai jadinya seperti ini nih. Gitu. Lama ini prosesnya. Jadi bisa satu minggu baru selesai satu karena kan lama. Kalau yang nggak usah dililit cuma gini aja ya 3 hari selesai. Cuma yang agak susah memang ini loh, motong ininya loh. Oh, kita harus rapi motongnya. Kalau nggak rapi ini nggak bisa ditekuk gini keras jadinya. Nggak bisa lentur ini. Gitu harus kalau motongnya itu harus apa namanya? Ini harus pas gitu loh ininya. Ini. Harus pas sampai itu. Kalau ada sisanya gitu enggak jadi kaku. Jadi bikinnya susah. Nah, kayak gini nih. Nah. Ini tadi enggak berhasil ini. Ini lepas ini harus loh ini kan kalau ada sisanya ini enggak bisa ditekuk. Jadi mesti apa namanya? Kita harus ruapi motongnya enggak boleh ada ini ada sisa di ininya gelasnya ini nggak boleh ada sisa di ininya harus tinggal sampai bersih ini lo kalau ada sisanya ini nggak bisa ditekuk agak susah dikit jadi mesti telaten motongnya ya agak susah ini jadi kalau nggak telaten ya nggak jadi tas ini makanya perlu ketelatenan ini kalau begini. Ini dari lehernya gelas aqua teh gelas itu enggak tas aja bisa dibikin untuk tirai juga ini hiasan buat kisi-kisi ini ya digantung-gantung gitu kan bisa nanti ini tapi ya mesti lama waktunya loh harus pakai cutter pakai gunting. Jadi kalau sudah gini bisa ditekuk gini. Kalau sudah nih tadi ditekuk jadinya kan kayak gini. Ini karena ini lepas jadi nggak bisa sempurna. Gitu. Kalau yang sempurna yang kayak gini nih. Nah, bisa dilihat. Kayak gini
jadi prosesnya mesti ini nggak bisa virtual, nggak bisa nih, harus kita langsung gini. Agak apa, agak ribet soalnya kalau yang ini gitu loh, mesti kelihatan. Nah ini kita harus ini moto, kalau sudah habis banyak, sudah dapat banyak, mesti kita lilit. Habis kita lilit, diginikan, dibentuk kayak gini nih, ditekuk kayak gini, mesti ditali, ditali ini, terus bentuk gini. Nah kalau sudah, ini dipertemukan. Nah ini masih lagi nih, dipertemukan lagi sampai dapat banyak gini. Tuh, kayak gini. Agak ribet pokoknya, tapi ya kalau daripada nganggur sih lumayan. Itu mungkin ada yang perlu ditanyakan.
Anyone wants to ask because
plastik glass. Coba diulangi.
Ada cerita yang bisa dibagi.
Kalau cerita saya sih, cuman kalau kita bikin ini sih bisa untuk ibu-ibu rumah tangga yang pengen menambah tambahan income, bisa ini untuk sambilan, bisa kita jual kayak di Bu Sandra itu. Kan sudah punya outlet sendiri, jadi bisa dijual menambah income. Kalau nanti punya kelompok kan enak, jadi tinggal ada pesanan sekian buah gitu kan, tinggal anu aja gitu aja. Kalau menurut saya ya nambah income lah buat ibu rumah tangga. Untuk tambahan biar dapurnya ngebul. Kalau saya seperti itu, di samping menyelamatkan lingkungan juga membantu pemerintah mengatasi masalah sampah, dan kita juga dapat pemasukan terutama untuk tambahan income, bisa dijual ya kan. Kalau ini jadi ya, misalnya ada tetangga-tetangga atau teman yang tertarik pesan, kan bisa dilayani, kan dapat pemasukan buat nambah-nambah. Nah, itu kalau menurut saya seperti itu, Bu Dewi. Hanya itu mungkin yang ya, bisa saya perhatikan.
Memang
Jarakan. Kok putus-putus ya Bu Devi ya?
Nggak tahu.
Putus-putus ini jaringannya, ini agak ini susah ini. Iya, kalau saya kira kalau kita menekuni ini bisa dibikin buat bisnis juga, Bu Devi. Ini kan juga ada peluang juga ini. Bisa menambah apa namanya, mengatasi pengangguran juga sebetulnya kalau kita tekuni kan. Jadi kalau untuk mengatasi pengangguran juga loh sebetulnya, kalau kita tekuni ini peluang juga Indonesia sebetulnya, bisa kita kita manfaatkan untuk yang masih belum, kan banyak yang di PHK itu sekarang masa pandemi itu. Ini sebetulnya bisa dimanfaatkan untuk yang kena PHK, terutama ibu-ibu. Kalau bapak-bapak biasanya kalau bikin gini kan enggak telaten ya. Biasanya kan ibu-ibu itu bisa kerja di rumah, kan? sambil ngomong anak, sambil apa gitu kan bisa disambi ini pekerjaan ini. Itu iya, kalau bisa iya, untuk peluang bisnis juga ini. Juga mengatasi pengangguran sebetulnya Bu Devi, kalau kalau ditekuni secara apa namanya? Secara benar gitu. Sebetulnya peluang juga gitu loh. Harus di anu ini. Apa namanya? Harus di lebih di apa fokuskan gitulah kalau menurut saya. Jadi untuk yang pengangguran gitu diberi keterampilan semacam ini, lah nanti kan bisa dijual kan nambah penghasilan, mengatasi pengangguran, di samping mengatasi masalah sampah, gitu kan? Dapat dua input ini, dapat uang, menjaga lingkungan juga, membantu pemerintah, mengatasi masalah sampah kan biar tidak merusak lingkungan, menurut saya seperti itu. Dan mungkin dari saya hanya itu mungkin.
Iya,
iya. Ibu makasih banget
ya. Iya. Maaf mungkin kalau ada kekilapan dari saya, mohon maaf saya pakai bahasa Indonesia, takut bahasa Inggris saya nggak begitu lancar, jadi saya nanti takut salah. Takut salah. Iya. Ya, translatornya Bu Devi aja nanti kalau yang untuk anu yang nggak bisa bahasa Indonesia dari India itu saya masih bahasa Indonesia aja. Hanya
terima kasih. Ya. Terima kasih banyak.
Ya mungkin lain kali bisa sharing lagi, kita bisa ketemuan, nambah ilmu lah kita. Saya siap membantu.
Okay.
Mohon maaf bila ada kata-kata saya yang kurang berkenan mungkin. Terima kasih atas waktu yang diberikan kepada saya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Salju.
Ada salju. Hey, Nyai Nurjana, gimana kabarnya?
Masak.
Ya, sama-sama.
Okay, thank you everyone. Good night.
Terima kasih.
Oh ada Maya. Lagi ngomong kali. Iya, Debbie-nya lagi nangis.
Ya sudah dulu ya.
Malam. Makasih. Bye.